You know, it's amazing to me that it took a small group of gay people and lesbians and LGBT community. At that time, the acronym was never. But anyway, but we were able to pull it together. And I think that spoke more about us as people than anything. You know, I was living in Boston when the big New York Times paper came out saying there are gay men with this mysterious cancer. And there wasn't a test during that time. There wasn't anything. We knew nothing. I mean, it was just one of those situations where we really didn't know anything for a long time. I came back here in 83. My friends were talking about this Good Samaritan Project thing, where it was an education thing, where you could go in, you could get fresh information, and it was being run by gay people, and it was kind of great. And just as I was going through my training, the executive director, she came by and she said, "I can tell that you're really into this." And she said, "Well, we just opened up hospice. Would you be interested in volunteering there?" Wasn't long, maybe a year of volunteering, that I quit my job and I was the assistant director. I've always been making art. At that time, I had a BFA in painting from KU and wanted to incorporate my experiences while I was working there. And I didn't know quite how I was going to really reconcile this, because I didn't want to be invasive, but I'd heard so many stories. While I was making this work, I was reading some older, actually it was in Time magazine, about men that were so scared to let anybody know that they were sick, that they were dying in their apartments. So I was taking that imagery, or the imagery I imagined from that, and the stories from the guys that were telling me, and I was making this amalgamation. Death was kind of, I wasn't scared of it anymore, because it's just a part of it. I mean, I had some residents that would fight all night long, chain stoking and doing the real typical kind of what you imagine in the movies, kind of dying. I mean, kind of lifting from the bed. And then I've had others that just went so peacefully and sweetly. I guess I don't talk about that part of it very much at all anymore, or maybe ever. And that seems so private, and I guess maybe that's part of it too. I mean, I've had a lot of years to separate myself from it. And I'm not saying there isn't a lot of sadness attached to all of that, but I think in some ways, I think being an artist and working and directly working through it as I was going through it, I think that helped. Thank you.